السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أتل ما أوحي إليك من الكتاب وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وأزواجه وذرياته. الله سبحانه وتعالى mentions in the glorious Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا، أو you who believe، اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا. Remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى in abundance. اذْكُرُ اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance. Remember Him again and again. Remember Him with your tongue. Remember Him with your heart and mind. And remember Him with your actions. سبحان الله، سبحان الله، الحمد لله، الله أكبر. This is remembering Allah سبحانه وتعالى with the tongue. And thinking Allah سبحانه وتعالى, thinking about the greatness of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, thinking about the favors of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, thinking about why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us. This is dhikr of the heart and mind. The first is dhikr lisani, the dhikr of the tongue. The other is dhikr qalbi, the dhikr of the heart and mind. There is a possibility that a person is remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his tongue, but not with his heart and mind. When we are performing salat, we say Allahu Akbar, سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيرك. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Salat is nothing but dhikr from beginning till end. وأقم الصلاة لذكري. Salat is dhikr from beginning till end. But how many of us do actually remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with our hearts and minds throughout this salah, from Allahu Akbar to Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah? So the dhikr of the tongue is there, but dhikr of the heart and the mind is not there. And many a times we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the heart and the mind, but not with the tongue. A person may be sick, ill, very weak, to say something with his tongue, but with his heart and mind he is communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, have mercy upon me. Oh Allah, make me better. Oh Allah, cure me. Oh Allah, grant me shifa. So one is the dhikr of the tongue, the other is the dhikr of the heart and mind. And sometimes they are combined also, that a person is saying Allahu Akbar and at the same time his heart and mind is connected to the meaning of Allahu Akbar. So dhikr qalbi, dhikr lisani, dhikr lisani, dhikr qalbi. And then the dhikr of the action, that is dhikr hali. Dhikr hali, the dhikr of the action. That means from the time we wake up in the morning until we go to sleep at night, we do everything according to the desire of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a person may leave his home in the morning to do shopping, and he may return after 1 hour, and he feels himself that I did not engage in dhikri lisani and I did not engage in dhikri qalbi also. For 1 hour I was outside and I can't remember remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I can't remember saying Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. But during that whole 1 hour, whenever the opportunity arose to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was able to control himself. That is a sign that he is in the remembrance of Allah. And this is the highest form of dhikr. Many people tend to think that dawame dhikr, perpetual dhikr. Dhikr with continuity means that at all times you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala physically. Allah is in your thoughts. Alhamdulillah, if a person is able to reach this stage, then whenever he is awake, he is remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he can feel remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can realize that he is remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his heart and mind. This is the zikr of a very high stage. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all this stage. And remember, my brothers, we can only become successful in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we have dawame ta'at. Dawame ta'at means throughout our lives, throughout our days and nights, we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we sleep and if we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we repent as soon as possible. As soon as we realize I have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we repent. This repentance is also obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, 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 and overcome by nafs and shaitan, we sleep, we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So dawam ta'at is gone. Obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with complete continuity is gone. In order to undo this break, in order to bring yourself back to the continual obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's very simple. One has to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-taibu min adh-dhanbi kamalla dhanba lahu. One who repents from a sin is like that person who has not committed a sin. So when this person is resurrected in the day of Qiyamah, his book of deeds will have no sins. So he will be like that person who spent all his life in Dawam-e-Ta'at. And Dawam-e-Ta'at, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with continuity is only possible with Dawam-e-Dhikr. If you continually remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then only Dawam-e-Ta'at is possible. So many people tend to think that I forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because my tongue is not remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because I cannot realize that my heart and mind is remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I am not in Dawam-e-Dhikr. My friends, if you are able to spend a day, if you are able to spend a week, if you are able to spend a month without disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is a sign that you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout your time. Because if you did not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would have fallen in the trap of shaitan. You are walking in the street and suddenly you meet a friend and he begins to engage in backbiting. He begins to engage in backbiting and you immediately realize that this is not permissible for me. And you say, brother, I am in a hurry, assalamu alaikum. How was it possible for you to realize that he is backbiting and if I listen to him, I will also become a shareholder in this sin of backbiting, therefore I need to make a move from here because you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people who carry out the do's of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those people who abstain from the don'ts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whether they realize this or not. This is zikr-e-hali. And this is the zikr that is demanded from you and me. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu zkurullaha zikran kathira. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance. How much? Alladhina yadhkurunallaha qiyaman wa qu'udan wa ala junubihim. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whilst you are standing. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whilst you are sitting. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whilst you are lying down. Sahib Jalalain rahimahullah ta'ala, the author of the well-known Tafsir Jalalain, he mentions under this verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the people of intellect, the clever people, the brainy people are those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whilst standing, whilst sitting, whilst lying down. That means the people of intellect are those people who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times throughout their lives, because these are the only three postures that a person can adopt. Either he is standing, or he is sitting, or he is lying down. There is no fourth posture. So dhikran kathira means you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times in a way that whenever the opportunity arises to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are able to resist that temptation and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us, Uzkurullaha dhikran kathira, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being very, very affectionate and kind. Because Allah knew that if my servants were to remember me throughout their days and throughout their nights, they will not be able to disobey me. So when Allah says, Uzkurullaha dhikran kathira, basically He is saying, that if you want to go in Jannah and if you want to save yourself from the fire of Jahannam, then remember me in abundance. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has also said, La yazalu lisanuka ratban min dhikrillah. Make sure that your tongue remains moist with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikr lisani, the dhikr of the tongue, brings one to dhikr qalbi. So when a person engages in dhikre lisani, then a time will come when the heart and mind will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And dhikre kalbi will take a person to the stage of dhikre hali. When a person remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at all times he will not be able to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when a person remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at all times he will never be grieved. He will never be grieved, because when we will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we will reach that stage, we will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all His greatness. So when a person remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his tongue, it will lead him to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his heart and mind. And when a person remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his heart and mind, this will lead him to always obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when a person reaches this stage, then he will find himself grief-proof. He will never experience grief in any circumstance. Why? Because 24 hours the thought of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in his heart and mind. And when a person is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when a person feels the support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when a person feels the nearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how can he grieve? How can he experience anxiety? How can he experience depression? Na duniya se, na daulat se, na ghar abad karne se, نہ دنیا سے نہ دولت سے نہ گھر آباد کرنے سے تسلی دل کو ملتی ہے خدا کو یاد کرنے سے. Through دنیا, through wealth, through material things, through big mansions and bungalows, a person is not able to acquire the contentment of heart. نہ دنیا سے نہ دولت سے نہ گھر آباد کرنے سے تسلی دل کو ملتی ہے خدا کو یاد کرنے سے. A person can only acquire the contentment of heart through remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is of the first level, then the contentment will be of the first level also. And when a person reaches the second level, then the contentment will also reach the second level. And if the remembrance is of the highest level, then the contentment will be of the highest level. So by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously, a person will not be able to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when a person remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously, he will never experience grief. Allah bi dhikrillahi tatma'innul qulub. Listen carefully. Only through the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hearts find peace, will hearts find contentment. So my friends, the beginning is the dhikr of the tongue. Let us make a firm resolution that inshallah we will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as we can. We will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as we can with our tongues, because the dhikr of the tongue will automatically lead us to the dhikr of the heart and the mind. Very simple. Remain engaged in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. fix an amount. Daily inshallah I will read kalima tayyiba 100 times. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Daily I will read istighfar 100 times. Astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. Daily I will read Salat Alam Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Durood Sharif 100 times. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shortest formula. The best Durood Pak is the one we recite in Salat. If one is able to recite that 100 times, Alhamdulillah. If not, then begin with the Durood that we recite in Salat. And with that durood, and in between read sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Hazrat Maulana Rashid Ahmad Gangohi rahmatullahi alayhi used to say that a person should recite salat ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in abundance. And he used to say that the minimum of abundance is 300 times. So if you are able to recite salat ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 300 times, alhamdulillah, the more the better. We need to fix some kind of azkar for ourselves and then religiously carry them out. Number one, fourth kalima, third kalima, first kalima, istighfar, subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah al-azim, whatever we are able to fix something, 500 times, 600 times per day. Zikr of the tongue, another way of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the tongue is to learn as many masnoon supplications as possible and read them. Bismillah wa barakatullah. Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amana wa saqana wa ja'alana muslimin. Allahumma aftah li abwaab rahmatik. Allahumma inni as'aluka min fadlik. When we sneeze, alhamdulillah. When we hear somebody say alhamdulillah after sneezing, yarhamukallah. When we meet each other, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. This is second method of engaging the tongue in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Third method, reciting the Quran as much as possible. Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the ulama are unanimous that the best form of dhikr is kitabullah. Recitation of the Quran is the best form of dhikr. So each person should make a firm resolution to recite the Quran on a daily basis. Allocate a quantity from the Quran, quarter of juz, half juz, three quarter of juz, but on a daily basis. Allocate the quantity, allocate time. Allocate two things. After asr, I will not leave the masjid until I recite a quarter juz. And then increase quarter to half, half to three quarter, three quarter to one. The more you recite, the more better it will be. Hazrat Maulana Abdullah Behlavi rahimahullah ta'ala, a very pious, saintly personality and very academic personality. He says that from amongst the causes of enlightening one's heart with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from amongst the causes, from amongst the things that will enlighten a person's heart with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one is the recitation of the Quran. So inshallah we will engage ourselves in the dhikr of the tongue, which will eventually lead us to the dhikr of the heart and the mind, and which will eventually lead us to the dhikr of the action, dhikr hali. Let us make this one resolution. Today, alhamdulillah, we are sitting in Masjid Muad ibn Jabal. And Masjid is a center of zikr. Ahabbul biladi ilallahi masajiduha. The most beloved places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the masajid. Why are masajid the most beloved places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because in masajid, only those activities can take place which comprises of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
That is why it is very beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In our homes, being dunya, both activities will take place. Certain activities will take place which has no connection with remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As far as the masajid are concerned, our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, إِنَّمَا بُنِيَتِنْ مَسَاجِدٌ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. The masajid are constructed only for the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us utilize the masajid for the dhikr of Allah. Be it Masjid Muadh ibn Jabal, be it Jami Masjid, be it Masjid Umar, be it Masjid Al-Falah, be it Islamic Daya Academy, Masjid Al-Khalil, Masjid Al-Bukhari, Masjid any masjid. As soon as you enter the masjid, from that time until you leave the masjid, make sure that you do not do anything which contravenes the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And alhamdulillah, three students of the madrasa run under the Masjid Muadh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu will be completing the Quran today, which is the highest form of dhikr. So masajid are constructed for dhikrullah. Use them for dhikrullah. Recite as much Quran as possible in the masjid at home, so that our hearts are illuminated with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when hearts are illuminated with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the ghaflat leaves the heart. Mawlana Muhammad Sahib, Hafidhahullah ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lengthen his age, and may Allah increase him in his ilm, and may Allah use him for the service of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He quoted Allama Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahimahullah ta'ala, that one of the effects of pious company is that the ghaflah leaves the heart. So when ghaflah leaves the heart, then the heart becomes awake. That means the heart becomes zakir. Through zikrullah, the hearts become zakir. Yad kar bas yad kar bas yad kar. Allah says, Udhkurullah zikram kathira. The poet is saying, yad kar bas yad kar bas yad kar. Remember Allah, remember Allah, remember Allah. Yad kar bas yad kar bas yad kar. Ghaflat unki yad se barbad kar. Destroy ghaflat through the remembrance of Allah. Yad kar, bas yad kar, bas yad kar. Remember Allah, remember Allah, remember Allah. Why? Through the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be able to destroy the ghaflat of your heart. Yad kar, bas yad kar, bas yad kar. Ghaflat unki yad se barbad kar. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frequently, my friends. If we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance, then the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when zikr penetrates the heart, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will penetrate the heart. And when zikr of Allah, love of Allah penetrates the heart, then the body has to follow the heart. If the heart is in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the heart will force the body to do only that which makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين.